In the first part, we have studied that this story, Children at Work, is a story of Velu, an 11-year-old boy who runs away from home and come to Chennai without a ticket in a train. And he was also very tired and hungry. He doesn't know where to go when a stranger girl at the station shouts a word of welcome. And Velu started following that girl. This we studied in the first part. Now come to the second part. Again, these 3 points you are seeing here are just the summary of the upcoming part. Now Velu was following that girl in the crowd because he doesn't know where to go. He caught up with the girl as she was leaving the station, means he was following the girl and the girl was leaving the station now. When they got to the road, Velu found that the vehicles kept coming and never stopped for anyone. Now they both were on the road, but Velu was not habitual of vehicles on the road. He was seeing that vehicles were coming and going and not stopping for anyone. And also smoke and dust was all around him due to vehicles. And this was making his head spin. Head spin means he was feeling dizzy. Chakkar aana, you can say. They had to wait for a long time before they could find a gap to run through. Now there were so many vehicles going on the road, so they were finding a gap to cross the road. Velu kept hesitating and the girl finally dragged him to the other side. But Velu was not feeling comfortable. He was not able to cross the road. Then the girl finally helped him to cross the road. What do you think you are doing? Grazing cows? Now, what that girl said to Velu, that what do you think you are doing on the middle of the road? Are you grazing cows? If you stand around in the middle of the road like that, you will be chutney. Now, girl said to that boy that if you will stand like this in the middle of the road, you will become chutney by any vehicle. As you can see in the picture. Velu's heart was still beating fast. Now, Velu's heart was beating fast. He looked back at Central Station and the traffic speeding by. Now, on the other side of the road, he was looking back at the Chennai Central Station and also the traffic, speed of traffic. How had they managed to come through that? They walked along the side of the road under some huge sign boards. Now they were walking and there were huge sign boards on the road, and you must have seen on the road there were huge sign boards. Velu looked up at the pictures, banyans, cars, tires, pens, and woman holding a box. When you also walk on the road, you see various boards of the advertisement. Same Velu was also seeing on the road. The writing was all in English, so he didn't know what it meant. Everything was written in English, so he was not able to read. The girl turned onto a wide bridge and walked up. Then the girl took a road to the wide bridge and they were walking. Velu stopped and peeped over the railing. Now on the bridge, Velu stopped and he was looking down from the railing. Under that railing, the road ran into the city. In the distance, he could see huge buildings and towers and more roads. Okay, he was seeing the whole city from that railing. See that big building with the wall around it. If you are not careful, you will soon be counting bars there. Okay, the girl was showing some big building with the wall and all around big walls were there. And the girl said that if you will not be careful, then you will be inside that bars. The girl grinned. Green means this. The girl smiled and pointed at huge building. Velu squinted and read the Tamil sign, Central Jail. Okay, it was Central Jail, that's why girl was smiling. Means she was kidding only and saying that if you will not be careful, you will be behind the jail. Why? I haven't done anything wrong. Velu said that I haven't done anything wrong. Why should I be in jail? Then girl said that you don't have to do anything. Just don't get caught by anyone. What does she mean? Velu wondered. Velu was thinking, what does she mean? But the girl was kidding only. Meanwhile, the girl was already heading down the bridge with the sack on her shoulder. Now, girl was leaving the bridge and the sack was already on her shoulder. What was in it? He had seen her putting plastic cups into it at the station. Now Velu was thinking that what is in the sack. He has seen her putting plastic cups into that sack in the station. Now he asked, "What are you carrying in that bag?" "Things, bottles, paper," girl said. "Things, bottles, paper." Velu wondered that what she was doing with them, but he felt shy to ask any more questions. Velu was thinking that what the girl will do with these kind of things, but he was feeling shy to ask these more questions. It was still morning, but the sun blasted on the tar and Velu's bare feet. But now it was the morning time and the sun was shining high. And Velu doesn't have any slipper in his foot, so his feet was burning. It was not like walking on a mud road. He was soaked with sweat and now he was feeling hot also. He tried hard to walk in the shade and keep up with the girl at the same time. He was trying to walk in the shade, means not in the sunlight, and also he was chasing the girl. She walked really fast. How far away was the food? He was thinking that the girl was walking very fast, and how far away was the food, because he was following that girl in the hope of food. After almost an hour of walking, they stopped in front of a big building. One big building was there. Shri Raja Rajeshwari Prashant Kalyan Mandap, read Velu slowly. Velu has read some of these lines outside the building. A sign with letters made of flowers said, "Groom J.V. Vinayan, Bride Rani." Okay, someone's marriage was there. Velu was reading this. Velu stared at the big cars parked outside. Now, big cars were parked outside the building and Velu was staring at that. One of the cars had a flower garland and roses tapped into it. What is the meaning of flower garland? You must be knowing. Like this. Mala, you can say Fuloki. And it was of roses. The girl looked around, pulled one off quickly and struck it in here. The girl went there and pulled one of the rose and put in her hair. "Come on," she said. Now again she was calling Velu. "Are we going to eat here?" asked Velu, looking at the huge hall and the people inside. Velu was looking at the huge hall of that wedding hall, and he asked that girl that, "Are we going to eat here?" "Hopes," said the girl, shaking her thumb under his nose. Now she said that, "Keep hope." She led him behind the hall, but she took him behind the hall, not inside the hall, but behind the hall. There was a big garbage bin overflowing with rubbish. She took him to the garbage bin where all the garbages were there. Two goats were standing on the pile fighting for a banana leaf. Two goats were standing there and they were fighting for a banana leaf. A cloud of flies buzzed around their legs, and now flies, mosquitoes, everything were there. There was a rotten smell in the air, and the air was also not very good. Very bad smell was there. The girl picked up a squashy banana and held it out to Velu. The girl from that garbage took out a squashy banana. Squashy means mashed totally, kuch pichle hue, and gave it to Velu. "Here's your food." Velu was shocked. He asked, "Are we going to eat their leftovers?" Leftovers means the one those things which are left by the people. So he asked, "Are we going to eat their leftovers?" "Chi, what do you think I am? A dog?" Now he asked to that girl, "Do you think I am a dog?" "I only take untouched food," he said. "Here's some more. Catch." Shri threw him a vada. Now she again took out some vada from that garbage. Velu looked at it with distaste. Now, Velu was looking with a disgust feeling to the girl, as you can see in the picture also. "Come on, hero, eat it. You think I like it? I told you I will find you something to eat. Don't think I have money to buy food for you." Now the girl said that, "Eat it. And don't think that this I like it, but I don't have money to buy food for you. So I am arranging what I can get. You would better eat what you get until you have your own money." देन द गर्ल सेड यू कैन ईट बेटर थिंग्स वंस यू अर्न योर ओन मनी. वैल्यू हेसिटेटेड. वैल्यू वॉज नॉट फीलिंग कम्फर्टेबल इन ईटिंग दैट थिंग बट ही वॉज वेरी हंग्री. हिज स्टमक स्क्विज्ड हिम अगेन. ही वॉज वेरी हंग्री एंड हिज स्टमक वॉज एम्प्टी. ही गल्प डाउन द बनाना एंड वड़ा. ही गल्प डाउन मीन सॉलोड क्विकली. यू कैन सी इन द हियर मीनिंग इज गिवेन हियर सॉलोड क्विकली. Now his stomach was feeling better now. He could have eaten at least 10 times more, but the girl could find only one more banana which she ate herself. He wanted to eat more, but the girl found only one more banana and that also she ate herself. It's too early. They have only eaten tiffin. If you are still hungry, you will have to wait for them to finish. Now girl said that they have in the marriage party, they have only eaten tiffin. That's why only little food is there. In some time they will finish lunch. You can wait if you want. I have to work. I am going. The girl said that you can wait if you want to eat more food. I have to work. I am going. She picked up a couple of bottles from the heap and threw it into her sack. From the garbage, she picked up again some bottles and put them in her sack. Then she walked off. Then she went from there. Velu panicked. Now, Velu was not feeling comfortable. Panic means ghabrana. He realized that if the girl left him, he had no idea where he was and what to do. Now, he was thinking that without the girl, he won't be able to go anywhere because he was unknown to that place. It was better to stick to her. She seemed to know her way around. He ran after her. Again, Velu was following that girl. Hey, he called. He did not even know the girl's name. Hey, what is your name? He asked, hurrying behind her. Now, Velu was not knowing the girl's name, so he was calling him. Hey, what is your name? She stopped and turned around. Oh, so you have been following me around without even knowing my name? The girl said, okay, you are the kind of a person who is following me without even knowing my name. And her name was Jaya. I am not following you. Velu said that he was not following her. What then? Who got you food? Then girl said that I have only given you food because you are following me. Can I come with you? Where are you going? Velu said that can I come with you? Where are you going? Come if you want. This bag is full. I have to go home to get another one. Girl said if you want you can come with me. And the sack on my shoulder is full now and I have to go home to get another sack to collect more things. This was the second part, and the third part we will discuss in next video.